Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophonet and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series. We're still here in Point Prometheus and we have three areas we need to go to. We have the optimized eugenics, Little Wonders educational facility and failsafe armored escorts. We'll try and head here first because this place looks a bit run down. Another suit control system.
After Ryan takes this place, here is where they build their filthy golems, their Frankenstein. Find the pieces of the suit. Guide them.
And we can clearly hear... Oh, okay. Hi. They're gonna die. There we go. You died. We can hear a little sister. Hi. Hi. Where's your daddy? There's your daddy. They're kind of in my way. Let's see here. I could hack these guys. Ooh, a pet bar. I could hack these guys, but... There are a lot of those, actually. Let's hack a few. How many can I hack? Yeah, it's two, so I can't hack two. I can actually go through here now. Okay, hi.
I'll go there soon.
Are they going through the lock? Okay, never mind, I'm gonna leave them be for now. Because I want to take a look around in peace. So, candidate conversion. So this is the area that they created, in which they created the Big Daddies. So we might as well find some interesting things here. Candidate induction. What is this place? As we can see over there, there's something over there. So let's see what that is. If we don't get hit by the turret. No, don't attack him. Oh, maybe attack him. There we go. Are there more turrets? No, okay, fine. So let's get the item that's right over here. Missing boots, but we kind of already know what this is going
to
tell us.
The Big Daddy boots need to be shipped here, not a damn library. What kind of idiot is Ryan hiring nowadays? This kind of bullshit never happened on the Fontaine.
So if you wouldn't have gone to the library first, you would have known it by this audio diary to go to the library for the boots. Hi, god damn it, you spooked me for some reason. Let's see, we have a safe over here in the corner. Let's auto-hack that immediately, because we have plenty of those. Steel screws, 14 art... First anti-personnel rounds and 3 kerosene. Not that stellar, actually. Let's see. We could... Well, we're gonna use telekinesis to just take out the bolts. And then the other side... Yep, that was great. Thank you, Bolt, to sacrifice yourself for me like that. Hi, a corpse. Could have used that as well, to be honest. Could have used the corpse. Anything of interest in here? We've searched all that. And then alcohol. Luckily, we don't drink that immediately. Let's hack this thing as well, because there might be something of interest in here. Nope, still the same thing. Might as well create the hack tool. And maybe some more armor-piercing rounds. There we go, and they spill out like that. I think there's a trophy for inventing a certain amount of items as well. So we might actually just do that. I could actually use that. There we go, a bunch of items we don't really need. Yeah, they just spill out like that if you don't really need them. So no boots in here, and that's actually all there is in the candidate induction area. But that's not all there is. Because this is actually pretty interesting as well. Might as well take incinerate with that oil slick over there. Hi. Yep, goodbye. You know what? Let's take that as well. Thank you. Let's take his organ, which serves us as a first aid kit since we researched him. Protector smell.
Big Daddy make a terrible stink. Very smelly. Maybe something can be done. But the little sisters seem to like odor. Now we have to find the recruits. You become Big Daddy, it's a one-way street. But Ryan says don't worry. Recruits will be no problem. That Ryan. He's a good guy.
So there we go. Ryan forced recruits onto the program. And the other interesting thing is that the smell of the Big Daddies is actually serves actually a purpose, because the little sisters like the smell so much, they just keep by his side automatically. So another reason for us to actually use that. Can we actually go through here? Doesn't look like it. There's an oil slick here, but it doesn't really do anything. There's an upper area here. Kinda misremembering this area a bit. Gonna first check out the downstairs. Because the further we get into the game, the harder it is for me to remember all the areas. This guy's dead. Definitely dead. Are you dead? Yeah, you are dead as well. There's another splicer over there, and it seems... Automatic hack tool. I think we can actually turn that off. Okay, yeah, okay. So those are the suits. We're gonna need one of those as well. So let's turn that on. Are you dead or not? I don't know. Don't care. Yeah, you're definitely dead. I think you would react to being set on fire. Let's see, how does this work again? I know you can do something with these thingies. But... okay, yeah, I can shut them off. So if I shut all of them off, I can actually move through there. Ooh, proximity mines. Well, let's hack that then. There we go. I want proximity mines. Give me that Eve Hypo. Thank you. Oh, and cheap son of a bitch. Cheap son of a bitch. Suchong again.
Scary son of a bitch. But Ryan, cheap son of a bitch. You can no reuse protector suit. Pagan man graft the skin and organs straight into suit. Otherwise your suit will not work. Ryan say Big Daddy too expensive. Ryan can go suck an egg.
And Suchong just told Ryan to go suck egg. That's not very nice of him. So yeah, Big Daddies are pretty expensive since you can't reuse the suits. As Suchong just mentioned, the Big Daddies, becoming a Big Daddy is a one-way street because the skin and organs are grafted right into the suit. Don't know how we'll do that in person, but well, we'll see about that now, shall we? Will you? Seriously? Yeah, die. What the hell? It's supposed to do immense damage. Napalm underwater, which is also fitting. I don't think there's anything else here. Could be hiding under the water, but I don't think there is anything. So let's... can we actually open these? No. No, never tried that. That's why I wanted to check that out. So there's a Big Daddy over there. So now he shot at the Big Daddy. Big Daddy is probably going to be mad at him for that, I'm assuming. Or not? Isn't he going to kill him? You should have killed him. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Goodbye. So that was the Big Daddy giving him a push. Just a little push. Let's see. So there's suits enough. Where you find body. No shit, Tannenbaum.
You're playing a bad hand, kid. You're just too spliced to smell it. Roll on back to Mother Goose now, or everything's gonna go busto.
So this is gonna give us an armor boost as well. So there we go. Big Daddy bodysuit gives you a 25% resistance to all damage. Something tells you that you'll need it. Yes, indeed. So there we have another splicer.
All you need now is helmet.
There we go. Goodbye. But that extra damage resistance will be pretty much unbeatable right now. I do want to have an explosive barrel of something. I know there's one in Candidate Induction. So let's quickly check him out. I love our footsteps, by the way, right now. Stoop, 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 stoop. So yeah, nothing of interest around here. Maybe go back down then. Candidate conversion, that's it. That's where we wanted to go. There we go, and there were a few of these, yeah, gas canisters over here. So let's grab one. I'm just gonna grab it along, hopefully don't come across any trouble. Oh, there's a splicer over there, so that might be a bit of trouble. Can I jump while holding these? Yeah, I can. So just stand over there, please. Stand over there. Yeah, please. Oh, god damn it. That was a heat-seeking rocket, but there you can see our damage resistance. I thought we had proximity mines equipped. Yeah, I don't really care anymore. There we go. You know what, Big Daddy? Just gonna use electric gel, I think. Let's check out the shotgun if we have electric buck equipped. So yeah, Fontaine just mentioned that we shouldn't save Rapture because there's nothing left to save. Let's just rescue her in the meantime. As we kinda didn't hear Fontaine over all the ruckus of the electric gel tearing down the Big Daddy, but hey. There we go, one out of three. Our last three big little sisters, by the way. Let's search him, brass tubes all the way, and our money has been refilled as well. You dead? Yes, you are. So the only thing we're... okay. Why isn't that thing attacking me? Don't really care. So the last thing we need is the voice processor, so we actually sound like a Big Daddy as well. Can we? Oh, four proximity mines. That's too bad. Wanted to have that. Okay, is there anything of interest in here? Nope. Really. I could actually buy that. Yeah, why not? I mean, we have all the money in the world right now. What the? That sounded really close. Those footsteps. Oh, up there. Never mind. Let's get the money back from the Big Daddy. Can we actually go through here? I'm wondering. I think we can enter this room if we have the code, but we don't have that yet. I could hack it, but I'm not gonna do that. Yeah, you're not doing anything anymore. So yeah, at this point the game is starting to get a bit too easy. Because we actually don't get damage anymore. We've been to candidate con... We have candidate induction and candidate conversion. So this is... Oh yeah, the previous area was induction, this is inversion. So the previous area was conversion and this is induction. And there's another little sister. Huh. Well then. Let's take proximity mines. One, two, three, four, and five. Let's take telekinesis. Is it? And since he's in water, that actually causes the effect to multiply even more, the electric effect. Hello, you're the second one in 5 minutes, I think. And now I am going to go back for those proximity mines. There we go. Two out of three. And let's take all that money back immediately. And you're welcome. Look at this. This place is starting to be run down. The little sister is walking me away. Helmet! A rosy helmet. I don't think we can actually choose. Yeah, they're all rosy helmets. So let's put this bad boy on. And there we go. This is our view for the rest of the game now.
Now we will find some pheromones for you on the voice box.
There we go. We still need two more items. Okay. No, I'm not afraid of you, because I kind of am in a Big Daddy suit right now. There we go. So this is a bit claustrophobic right now, because we do lose a bit of our sight. Let's see. Let's annoy you. I think that's hurting you. Seriously? Yep. Goodbye. That actually worked pretty well, electric bugs. I think it's kind of weird how sometimes the enemies scale and sometimes they don't. I hear another one. But I'm not seeing it. Never mind. Atomic, Hacker's Delight 3. The ultimate development of the Hacker's Delight line. This will make every hacker a healthy hacker. Every time you hack something, you gain a large amount of health and Eve. We don't really hack all that much anymore, so not really useful for us. Can we check these thingies? No. And that's about it for this area, I believe. Don't see any more audio diaries either. This guy is still dead. So yeah. Is there a problem? Or is that another little sister I hear? Not the main hall. We need to go to suit assembly again. Yeah. There we go. And then in this... Yeah, fuck off. I don't care. I love it. So there were proximity mines over here on the left. Thank you. And now we can actually go back to the main hall until we get the code. I think he's upstairs. Yeah. Don't really care. So let's go into the hallway again. And move back out. There we go. Did we actually go through here the last time? Yeah, we did. There we go. So that's failsafe armor conversion, I think it's called. Gonna have to check. Okay then. That was interesting.
Run the table in this place. Now there's nothing left for you but a long cold nothing.
Thank you, Fontaine. I think we're getting it by now. You're threatening us all the way. Yeah, there we go. So let's hack this thing. You can follow us. Houdini splicer kind of died. This one also. Did you see how that rocket just swirled around the splicer? That was really, really weird. Okay, so we have little wonders left over there. And optimized eugenics over there. So let's go across the way first. Oh, this seems to be frozen over for some reason. We're gonna check out this thing as well. Just an automatic hack tool, not really useful. Now we should be able to enter this place. Yeah, okay. Hmm. Fontaine Futuristics. Huh, the doors to Fontaine Futuristics. So we can assume with that information that this used to be Fontaine Futuristics, but we know that Andrew Ryan took that over. So the genetic research facility was bought over by Andrew Ryan, and it turned into optimized eugenics. But seems to be a few things here. A lockbox with some nice loot, actually. Cigarettes. I shouldn't have taken that. Cigarettes are bad for you, dollars. But we have all the money in the world. And then, changing employers.
Bad for Fontaine. Good for Su Chong. Play hard to get for a bit. Then Mr. Ryan get hungry for me. Tenenbaum gone, Fontaine gone. Su Chong only one who know all about little sister. Like I said, it's very good for Su Chong.
So as he states himself, we know Su Chong worked for Fontaine and created the plasmids, Adam, and all the little sister research when he was working for Fontaine alongside Tenenbaum. And of course, with Fontaine dead, he tried to make the best of it and started working for Ryan at a pretty big pay rate, probably. So let's head into optimized eugenics. Is there something in here? Cigarettes.
Here is where you'll be finding the voice box to have sound like one of those big daddies. Repulsive creatures.
Okay, so let's... Oh, for fuck's sake. Are we seriously gonna get attacked right now? Where's the bolt shutdown? Here in the middle, apparently. And here? And here? No? Oh shit, electro bolt. I need electro bolt. There we go. Bolt shutdown. Thank you. So let's head to that. Two bullets should be enough. Can you open the door, please? There we go. Okay, and the door just closed again. God damn it. There we go. So all the cameras taken care of. I don't really care about cameras anymore. It appears there's one around the corner here as well, though. Or not. Never mind. Okay, so this is a really cool area, eugenics, optimized eugenics. So let's head into each area one by one, starting with test subject storage. What's in here? Well, probably they store test subjects, but test subjects for what, you might wonder. Okay, thank you for that, and all the dollars in the world. Then we have another splicer. There we go. He's dead. Wonder if we actually can find any evidence of what is actually tested here. There we go. Goodbye. Let's head into the next room, because there doesn't seem to be much here. Don't really see anything anyway. So a room that's pretty much very similar to this one, to the one before. Oh, another Eve Hypo, not really useful for us. And another Big Daddy for some reason. We know about the explosives over there in the main area, so might as well get one. Oh, there's one over here as well. So proximity mines, let's reload. And rinse and repeat as we always do. Yeah, we can get everything in there. Let's swap to electric bucks. And let's go for telekinesis. And hopefully the little sister didn't leave yet. Okay, that was annoying. Yeah, he's down. Where's the little sister? Mr. Bubbles is dead. Where? I hear you. Oh, there you are. And I think that's our last little sister, actually. If I'm not mistaken, except if everything in here... No, tree out of tree. There we go, dealt with every little sister.
Thank you, mister.
How can I thank you?
Thank you.
I send another little one with a token of our appreciation.
There we go. And that's actually the last little sister we needed to deal with. So no Big Daddies anymore, so we can completely focus ourselves to killing every splicer in the building. But first, marketing gold.
I admit Fontaine showed some foresight when he built up the plasmid business. But the man really never understood sales. Hiding those little girls beneath a bushel. I've just seen the preliminary design work on the new plasmid machines. And they're exactly what I wanted. Mark my words. Presented properly, those little sisters are marketing gold.
So there you go. As you might have realized already, the little sisters weren't originally public knowledge as they were at the moment that Andrew Ryan started using them. Andrew Ryan bought Fontaine's business after he was allegedly killed, and then he used the little sisters to make them a bit more public, and it's only then that everybody started to realize what Adam could do. Because Fontaine kind of kept that under the rug most of the time. And Andrew Ryan built out the empire further. So that was test subject storage. And judging from the audio diary, the test subjects in here were actually little sisters. And then in the next room, we have eugenics analysis. Difficult words. Difficult words.
Look around you, kid. You think two-bit heroics count for a fig in this pit? You're staring down the puke stain of Ryan's busted dream. You think there's something worth saving down here? And you deserve to gargle with the rest of these scrubs.
There we go, two turrets, and hacked both of them. And a bit more generic bumbling from Fontaine, just still simply attacking us. Can I move past you? Okay, thank you. I'm starting to get a bit too wide for everything, since I'm a Big Daddy right now. And there we have another very interesting thing, the last power to the people station. So yeah, pistol clip size probably. There we go. Let's swap that over to 24. And that's all the rounds in the world. It are mags, a trophy earned weapon specialist, upgrading every weapon to the max. Another safe over here, but this is actually more important. And then hack it. Yeah, there we go. Napalm and armor piercing rounds. And yeah, turrets are doing their work. Two rocket turrets. Nobody's coming across this place. Yeah. pretty much nothing else in here, apparently. I thought there was another audio diary here, but apparently there isn't. There isn't. Nope, nothing here. Let's go to the other side, because there's another room here, if I'm not mistaken. Seriously? You know what? Burn, motherfucker! Where are you going? Is he gonna go to a healing station? That's annoying, because I can't enter the building without setting myself on fire. Can you stop, please? Stop burning. The oil should have disappeared. No, no, he didn't. What? Oh, there's a camera over there. Seriously? First, take you out. And then I'm gonna go towards that center area, the security office. Oh, God. Damn you! And let's turn that off again. Yeah, there we go. I think there must be a few turrets. Yeah, there's a few turrets around here now. Thank you. So let's head in here. So this place is electrified. You can't really go through here. I think there's a way to turn off the power. Could be on the other side. I'm gonna see about that. Okay, so then we have plasmid prototyping. We might as well find something interesting here. Thank you, that's ours. Yes, I'm leaving you, because I don't really like you. I'm gonna let the turret do all the work, actually. Yep, yeah, bye. Wait, yeah, okay. I knew that was gonna happen. He was going to fire on the corpse a bit more. So that's it, probably, right? Audio diary, extra munitions. Nope, no, not the corpse. Audio diary.
Ryan sent over extra munitions. He must suspect the trouble. I will lock them up near the protector labs and set the code to 1921. I don't expect we'll ever be needing them, though. Once Big Daddy is ready, nobody crossed the Big Daddy.
So there we go. Extra munitions in the area that was locked off, 1921. And now we're gonna open up in a second, but we still have a few areas over here on the left. Okay, yeah, over here. And this is called live subject testing. And apparently something escaped from the live subject testing. We can actually go further around the back here. Just gonna check out if nobody's still alive here. That thing actually exploded by the looks of it. What's this? Candidate induction? We've already been to candidate induction. That's the wrong area, right? Live subject testing. So we're still here for the voice control module. And that's right over there.
Turning yourself into one of those tin men is a two-way street. The crowd's holding auditions for the Frankenstein parade, and you're first in line.
Yeah, we kind of already realized that it's a one-way street, but if it's a way to kill you, then why not, eh? Look at that bloody claw. Voice box modification machine. That's not just implanting something. It's sticking that in my throat somewhere. But hey, here we go.
Look at you. We will make Big Daddy out of you yet, I think. There is only one piece missing, the pheromones. Go to the Little Wonders educational facility.
There we go, voice boxes. Now we actually sound like a Big Daddy. Don't know if we can actually... That didn't really sound like a Big Daddy now, did it? But hey, Alarm Expert 2, let's power up with that. Are your hacks still being interrupted by alarms? And you need Alarm Expert 2 today, a Hack Smart Gene Tonic. Four fewer alarm dials while hacking. Well, I have the original Alarm Expert, so let's just swap that out. And that's about it for this area. I think no more audio diaries in here either. Okay, there's Fontaine again.
Has Mother Goose really got her hooks into you? You can knock Ryan all you want, but the old man was bingo on one point of fact. You won't even walk till somebody says go.
Yeah, yeah, yada, yada, yada. Let's hack this thing as well. You invent... we can't make an automatic hack tool. We can actually make electric shell. We need that quite a bit. And then let's go for exploding bugs a bit more. Still not at the trophy, apparently, which is interesting to say the least. Since we don't really need to fight any big daddies anymore, I'm just gonna go with exploding bugs and anti-personnel rounds. Because that's all we really need, really. Except for maybe the occasional... Oh, hi. Yeah, as you can hear now, we sound like a big daddy. Hi. 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 Yeah, is that hurting? Yeah, I thought it was hurting. Let's take all that. I'm just gonna quickly nip back to the UN vent since we made all those exploding bugs. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, okay, there we go. So let's run around with this thing a bit more. We haven't been using this for a while now. I think we can... Okay, do we need to shock it again? There we go then. I think there's a way to shut down the electricity, if I'm not mistaken. Don't really know how... Oh, there we go. There's the breaker. So let's turn that off, and now we can go back around. There we go. Let's auto-hack it. Okay, we're all set over here, apparently. Don't really care about you right now. So we've been through all the areas around here, so let's head back to failsafe armored escorts and open up that door.
You know, you should be thanking me. I brought you here. I showed you who you are.
Ooh.
Nobody never told you nothing but lies till I come along.
Well, those little sisters are bringing me gifts. I mean, I can't kill them if they're bringing me gifts. Come on. So let's check this out. The last gift, 200 atom, 100 anti-personnel rounds, and a bit of liquid nitrogen. So let's, buy our last upgrades, because we won't get anything else for now. So, let's buy the two last bits of insect swarm. There we go. And electro bolt. There we go. The last upgrades for that. And then we can upgrade our health and our Eve once more. There we go. And that's about it, actually. That's pretty much it. Can't buy anything else anymore, so 70 atom to spare, apparently. So there we go, nice big bars of health and Eve, by the way. Don't look into that too much. So let's open up the door around. Yeah, goodbye. That's the little sister that brought us our gift. So let's head in here. That's wrong. I'm sorry. It's the suit assembly. Hi. You want a shotgun to the face? Yeah, that was a complete miss. But we're here for something else. We're here for that door over there. So if I'm not mistaken, that was 1921. There we go. And look at that. Look at that. More crafting materials we don't really need anymore. Are there proximity mines? I would like proximity mines. Oh, no, okay, incendiary bolts, we're full up on that as well. Oh, there we go, proximity mines. And armor piercing round, so that filled us up pretty nice. I'm gonna shut down these things. Can we can actually burn these suits as well for some reason, don't know. I think it was meant to test their fireproofness, something like that. The tank, I'm not really sure if we can go through these right now. So we can go in here, but I think we can't pass through the... Oh, we can. Is there something behind this place? There we go. Apparently not. Nothing around here. Okay, so let's head back to the center area, to the main hall. And then we have the last area we need to go to for the pheromones. The Big Daddy smell, as they put it. And that should be in the Little Wonders educational facility. So let's see. Main hall. Yeah. Clean us a bit. There we go. And then we should go over here. To this lovely place. Little Wonders Educational Facility. Oh! Camera. That was a camera.
We bred little ones to imprint a certain smell, the pheromone. But this is not like putting on aftershave. You will need 3 industrial applications of this stuff, and then the little ones will be drawn to you like a bee to honey. You will have to gather 3 pheromones here, so that you smell disgusting. Just like a big daddy.
So yeah, we need to find 3 samples of the pheromones that draws the little sister towards us. And that should be enough to make us into a complete big daddy. But that will be for next episode, because I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode and I really liked us becoming a big daddy, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you can give me. And you can support my my mumbling a bit. But with that said, thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. I'm gonna let this run for now.
When you're cold and stiff, I'm gonna go over to Mother Goose's house, and I'm gonna take it apart piece by piece and brat by brat. Consider it your legacy.
Well, we'll handle you in the next episode, Fontaine. So, goodbye, you guys. Goodbye.